the principle that every adult must know well to prevent kidnapping children. Remember, kidnappings can happen anywhere, with any family and victim of any age, from preschool to elementary school, to newly born babies. Parents need to remember the following, in order to minimize the risk to their children. For infants. Neonates or infants less than 2 years old are not sufficiently conscious that the subject can protect the child as an adult. In fact, many kidnappings occur even in the hospital, and all come from parental loopholes. For infants, absolutely do not forget the following. Do not leave the child alone in the room. Watch out for people who are not familiar but are too close. Absolutely no help for strangers. The scenario is often seen in kidnappings, which are abductors pretending to be familiar with visiting women, even pretending to be medical workers, taking advantage of the loopholes to hold the children. When in hospital, need to get familiar with midwife. Be alert to anyone who intends to take her out of the room. When removing the child from the room, do not carry it by hand. It is best to place your baby on a crib and tie it securely. Otherwise, at least use the baby straps firmly on the body. Only play in closed camps and assisted living areas, but not overcrowded. Another common scenario is that kidnappings take advantage of traffic crashes to steal the child. So when there is a need for traffic, it is advisable to use a taxi, or at least travel with an adult. For the children have been conscious. At this age, protection is not limited to adults, but children need to know the knowledge they need to protect themselves. 1. Teach children to shout loudly when they feel unsafe. Here it is most important to teach the child what is not safe. That is when the stranger approached, solicited, seduced to follow. 2. Know how to reject gifts from strangers. Again, the kidnappers can use candy, cake, toys, eye-catching to attract children to follow them. Therefore, parents need to teach absolute children never receive gifts from strangers without parents next door. 3. Keep calm when getting lost. Teach children about safe strangers. Let your child know how to handle straying, which is to run into the protected area such as supermarkets, shops, or police station. These are safe strangers. Before then, make sure you remember your parents' phone number and home address. 4. Actual video capture situations are kidnapped. Watch the report. The clip simulation situation is unsafe. Those videos are easy to find on YouTube, and then you can train young methods of dealing with similar cases. Parents watch the video of the incident, the clip of the simulation, describing the unsafe situation that other children encounter when not in the same parent. Parents can then elicit and answer their questions as they watch these videos so they can form their own sense of protection in similar situations that can happen to their children if they are encountered. 5. Be alert to solicitations, help. Children, who are essentially adults now, may still remember the teachings of their parents in the past, to love and help others. However, that may not be a good idea, because bad guys can take advantage of this and get them out of the loop. Instead, teach children how to distinguish situations that need help. Situations are really difficult, people will find another adult, not a child. Teach your child to respond to strangers, I do not know you, your mom, dad there, so I ask your mother, father for help. When children are child. That's when adults need to scream, loud from, cube to attract attention. And in the case of kidnappers with weapons of mass destruction, immediately observe and remember all possible characteristics, face, car, number plate, to inform the authorities. 6. Use password, simple but be sure to be secret. When children go to school or send children, parents give a password to the baby. Only your parents or your children will know the password. When picking up the baby, whisper the password to the ear to practice the habit. At the same time, please remind me that, whether relatives or strangers to pick up, I have to ask for password. If the picker does not speak the password, he or she immediately runs away and asks for help from the surrounding people. 7. What should I do if there are strangers to candy? teach her to be polite and resolutely refuse the candy of strangers and quickly return to the person who is with her. To prevent the gift, cake, candy that is impregnated with anesthetics, baby smell or it will be hit by the guile of bad guys, parents should teach children not to receive any item of strangers to refuse my parents do not allow me to receive. Then go to the place where there is an adult or guard standing to avoid being strangled by another person. 8. What should I do if a stranger pulls my hand? In case your baby is dragged away, teach him to cry for help. Remember your home or parent phone number is what parents need to teach their children. Parents should repeat this case every day, for practice. I often asked my grandmother, imagine a stranger pulling my hand and calling for my mother to see it. Collection will reflect the baby. 9. Do not talk to strangers. Parents need to teach this skill and let their children know when a stranger is approaching, they must flee immediately and talk to their parents or people like, police, firefighters, security guards or shop staff to ask for help. 10. Teach children to keep an eye on their parents. In a crowded neighborhood or supermarket, you never look away from your child for fear of being lost. Similarly, you teach the child the same way, always keep an eye on the parents and when the parents are out of sight, call out loud. 11. Teach children to self-defense. If your baby does not know the martial arts, then you need to guide the child with simple resistance when approaching strangers, kicking the strangers, knees and sensitive areas of the stranger and trying to shout real big. I'm not my mom, dad to get the attention of the people around and have a chance to run away. Kicking in sensitive places is the most effective way to get rid of strangers. 12. Always remember your parents' phone number. Please help your baby remember the exact number of parents in case the bad situation happens, the child can be protected, the police, call for parents. At least he must remember two numbers of family members. More and more information about children in preschool age, primary school missing, kidnapping, is a mother so I have to worry about the children, because the danger of this type is not rare. Just a little bit of our subjectivity, can be filled with children forever away from his arms. Moms have the skills necessary for the baby.